I Thank you. really, truly proud of this group, because this is the group of kids that has lost the most instruction when schools closed down. And from that, we started the year a little bit lower than we normally do, but they've worked hard, and I'm really proud of the way they sound today. So please give them another round of applause. Okay, and earlier in the year, we had a group of kids travel to, oh my gosh, where was that at? Where was County Bend at? North Clarion High School. And spend the day making great music. Will those kids who went to County Bend please stand to be recognized? And was it this past Friday? We had a group of kids go to Dubois High School to participate in District 3 Band Fest. Will those students please stand and be recognized? I think they left the school at 7 o'clock in the morning, so it was a very long day, but a great day of making music. We'll close the junior high portion of the concert with themes from Black Panther.
Thank you.
while Concert Band quietly gets set up on stage, I wanted to talk a little bit about our first piece. Every year we travel to Clarion High School to participate in Concert Band adjudication, and we play two prepared pieces for that festival. This is one of them, and this piece is Drums of the Sawmies. The piece chronicles the merger of the First Nation and modern Albertan Canada cultures. The chronological merger is symbolized in both melodic themes and percussion themes. The piece begins with the tribal drums of the First Nation, synonymous with Native American, First Natives of the American continent. The well-known and associated four-beat drum pattern dominates with light syncopation, accompaniment, foreshadowing of the modernistic tune to come. The next entrance is the flute playing in the style of the First Nation, wooden flute with large intervallic grace note skips and portamento, which means pitch sliding. These two themes set the foundation for the entire piece as they never disappear, but rather are enhanced with the ornamentation, counter melodies, and full orchestration accompaniment. Throughout the entire composition, little by little, we hear the presence of the modern day Alberta, Canada becoming more prevalent through modern sounding chords. By the end of the piece, the marriage of the old and the new is complete. First Nation drumming becomes the basis for various percussive grooves around it, and the primary melody is accompanied by lush chords that rise beneath it. Drums closes as it began, with a simple beat and solo flute, restating the foundation of the music and the region's history. And this piece was written by Sam Hazo, who is a native of Pittsburgh. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
Our next piece is Symphonic Suite from Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. While the choir is just rocking out to pop songs for our Pops concert, our concert band is doing the most challenging repertoire that we can to get ready for adjudication. And after adjudication, I always let the kids pick out a theme or a song that they want to play, thinking, oh, maybe we'll pick something from a movie, something that's fun. Well, they wanted to do something from Harry Potter. And I looked and I looked, and the only things that are good that you can play from Harry Potter are tremendously difficult. I mean, like, impossibly difficult. But they really wanted to try it. So I got the music and I said, well, we'll see how this goes. So we'll see how this goes. Please enjoy. Have you ever had that feeling that you lost your second bass drum mallet? Can we have an extra round of applause for Jacob Hoffman on the harp part and Bella Black on the piano part? Okay, the high school band has had quite a few opportunities to participate in music festivals, so let's start with Honors Band that took place back in the fall. So any student who participated in Honors Band at Clarion High School, please stand. Any student who participated in County Band in the fall, please stand. Will any of our ninth graders who participated in District 3 Band Fest last week, please stand. Every year we participate in the District Band and District Choir Festivals, and Keystone always has a great showing to those festivals. Will any student who competed in the District Band Festival this year please stand? Now here's a really cool one. Will any student who had advanced on, that means they placed in the top half of their section, when competing against 30 schools, from five counties. So any student who moved on to Region Band, please stand. And we had two students that were, so close to making it on the All-State Festival. And neither of them were seniors, so we're hopeful for next year. Our next piece on the program is the second piece that we played at Concert Band Adjudication. And it is called Ruckus. Now, I have to say, the percussion was really upset with me after the Christmas concert because they said I didn't pick enough things with percussion in them. So enjoy this one. Thank you. also want to recognize Lilia Demmer, who has joined us for Mallet and a couple other things. I think she just snuck to go back right there. But she is an eighth grader who is a great piano player and great mallet player. Thank you for helping us. There she is. Give a wave, Lilia. Thank you. Okay, now I'm going to turn the microphone over to our KMA president, Carrie Thompson, for the Senior Awards and Recognition.
Tonight's concert was amazing, so congratulations on your musical journey. As we get ready to wrap up the next few weeks of school, I want to just give you a couple of friendly music reminders as you move into the next chapters of your life. First off, practice doesn't make perfect, but it does provide room and create room for improvement. Second, music gives a soul to the universe, wings to the mind and flight to the imagination, and life to everything. Don't forget all that you learned at Keystone in the music department. So on behalf of KMA, I'd like to take a moment to recognize the senior band members. So as we recognize your name, please come forward to receive your award. First up, I have Sydney Bell. Elizabeth Fish. Yes, you have to stay. Okay. Josephine Kinsler. Shiva Lenhart. Excluded from that voting process, but we have a chance to vote on some great students, and it was a very challenging vote this year. But we have a chance to recognize this year for our Arian Award for Band, Shyla Lenhart. For us. It's the Musician of the Year Award, and this award is chosen by the members of the music department. The students vote on their peers, and it can go to any student in the department. I do want to read what's on the plaque. So it reads on here, chosen by your peers for displaying the best in leadership, integrity, respect, dedication, and musicianship. And I was told that this was a landslide vote for Shiloh Linhart. So congratulations, seniors. I know your parents want to take pictures, so parents, I'm going to direct them. Seniors, we're going to want to make eye contact here. We're going to do a picture at the end so that all the parents, grandparents, friends who want to get a picture at the end can do that. Okay, we're good? Awesome. Thank you. Congratulations.
So before we play our final song, I wanted to thank my colleague Tom Bowser for always being here and helping with the lights and the sound and getting these kids ready for junior high band and senior high band. Can you please give them a round of applause for them? And I'd like to also thank all of our administrators. Many of you know we had a complete administrative turnover this year, a new principal, a new assistant principal, a new superintendent, and I couldn't be happier with the way all of them have been treating the music department and how they interact with the kids. So if you see them, please tell them thank you for everything they did, because what you see on this stage is not possible without their support. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you. coming out tonight, and have a safe trip home.